Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Vivek and today I will share 320 questions and answers for Azure AI Engineer Associate or AI 102. If you want to download all questions and answers, feel free to visit Buy Me a Coffee page. I have shared the link below. You can then click on the shop. There are two courses, one with explanation and one without. Choose any one you prefer. Enter the amount, pay and download them. If you join a membership, then every course will be 25% off. Now, let's get started. Question number one. You are building a chatbot. You need to use the Content Moderator API to identify aggressive and sexually explicit language. Which three settings should you configure? Option A, resource name. Option B, autocorrect. Option C, PII. Option D, list ID. Option E, classify. Option F, language. Option G, content type. Option H, OCP, APIM, subscription key. The correct answers are option A, resource name. Option E, classify. Option at OCP APIM subscription key. Resource name. This specifies the name of the content moderator resource that you are using, ensuring that the API calls are directed to the correct resource. Classify. Setting this parameter to true enables the classification features of the Content Moderator API, which is necessary to identify aggressive and sexually explicit language. OCP APIM subscription key. This is the subscription key required to authenticate and authorize your API request. Question number 2. You plan to deploy an Azure OpenAI resource by using an Azure Resource Manager ARM template. You need to ensure that the resource can respond to 600 requests per minute. You need to complete the template. Which value should you choose for placeholder 1? Option A, capacity. Option B, count. Option C, max value. Option D, size. The correct answer is option A, capacity. It specifies the scale unit of the deployment, which determines the number of requests the resource can handle per minute. Setting the appropriate capacity value ensures that the resource can respond to 600 requests per minute. Question number 3. You plan to deploy an Azure OpenAI resource by using an Azure Resource Manager ARM template. You need to ensure that the resource can respond to 600 requests per minute. You need to complete the template. Which value should you choose for placeholder 2? Option A, 1. Option B, 60. Option C, 100. Option D, 600. The correct answer is option C, 100. Throughput of 600 requests per minute requires the ability to process a substantial number of tokens per minute. Its capacity unit supports 1,000 tokens per minute, TPM. For a typical request, assuming it processes up to 100 tokens per request, input plus output, the capacity required is 600 requests times 100 tokens equals 60,000 TPM. Setting the capacity to 100 ensures the resource can handle up to 100,000 TPM, meeting the 600 requests per minute requirement with sufficient buffer. Question number 4. You are building an app that will share user images. You need to configure the app to meet the following requirements. Uploaded images must be scanned and any text must be extracted from the images. Extracted text must be analyzed for the presence of profane language. The solution must minimize development effort. What should you use for the text extraction requirement? Option A, Azure AI language. Option B, Azure AI Fusion. Option C, Azure AI Content Safety. Option D, Azure AI Custom Vision. The correct answer is Option B, Azure AI Fusion. Azure AI Vision includes OCR, optical character recognition capabilities that can extract text from images automatically. It is specifically designed for analyzing visual content, making it the most suitable and low-effort solution for extracting text from uploaded images in an app. Question number 5. You are building an app that will share user images. You need to configure the app to meet the following requirements. Uploaded images must be scanned and any text must be extracted from the images. Extracted text must be analyzed for the presence of profane language. The solution must minimize development effort. What should you use for the profane language detection requirement? Option A, Azure AI language. Option B, Azure AI Fusion. Option C, Azure AI Content Safety. Option D, Azure AI Custom Vision. The correct answer is Option C, Azure AI Content Safety. Azure AI Content Safety is designed to detect harmful and offensive content, including profane language, in both text and images. It provides pre-built capabilities that require minimal development effort, making it the ideal choice for analyzing extracted text for profanity. Just a quick reminder, if you don't have time to watch these videos and instead download all questions and answers, feel free to purchase them on Buy Me a Coffee page. I have shared the link below. Question number 6. You have an Azure subscription that contains a multi-service Azure Cognitive Services translator resource named Translator 1. You are building an app that will translate text and documents by using Translator 1. You need to create the REST API request for the app. Which headers should you include in the request? Option A, the access control request, the content type, and the content length. Option B, the subscription key and the client trace ID. Option C, the resource ID and the content language. Option D, the subscription key, the subscription region, and the content type. The correct answer is option D, the subscription key, the subscription region, and the content type. When calling the Azure Translator REST API, you must include the subscription key for authentication, the subscription region to route the request correctly, and the content type, for example, application/JSON, to specify the format of the request body. These are required for successful API communication. Question number 7. You have an Azure subscription. The subscription contains an Azure OpenAI resource that hosts a GPT 3.5 turbo model named Model 1. You configure Model 1 to use the following system message. You are an AI assistant that helps people solve mathematical puzzles. Explain your answers as if the request is by a 4-year-old. Which type of prompt engineering technique is this an example of? Option A, few-shot learning. Option B, affordance. Option C, chain of thought. Option D, priming. The correct answer is option D, priming. Priming involves setting the behavior or tone of the AI model using a system message or initial prompt. In this case, configuring the system message to guide how Model 1 should respond is a classic example of priming to influence the assistant persona and response style. Question number 8. You build a chatbot by using Azure OpenAI Studio. You need to ensure that the responses are more deterministic and less creative. Which two parameters should you configure? Option A, max response. Option B, temperature. Option C, top B. Option D, stop sequence. The correct answers are option B, temperature. Option C, top B. Make chatbot responses more deterministic and less creative, you should lower the temperature, which controls randomness, and top B, which limits the pool of likely next tokens. Lower values for both results in more focused, predictable, and repetitive responses. Temperature near zero makes output highly deterministic, while top B filters out least likely words, reducing variation further. Question number 9. You are building an app that will use the Azure AI Video Indexer service. You plan to train a language model to recognize industry-specific terms. You need to upload a file that contains the industry-specific terms. Which file format should you use? Option A, XML. Option B, TXT. Option C, XLS. Option D, PDF. The correct answer is option B, TXT. Azure AI Video Indexer requires a plain text TXT file to upload custom vocabulary such as industry-specific terms. The TXT format is simple, structured as one term per line, and supported by the service for training language models to improve transcription accuracy. Question number 10. You are building an app that will include 1 million scanned magazine articles. Each article will be stored as an image file. You need to configure the app to extract text from the images. The solution must minimize development effort. What should you include in the solution? Option A, computer vision image analysis. Option B, the read API in computer vision. Option C, Azure AI document intelligence. Option D, Azure Cognitive Service for language. The correct answer is option B, the read API in computer vision. The read API is specifically designed to extract printed and handwritten text from images with high accuracy. It supports large-scale OCR tasks like processing scanned articles and requires minimal setup, making it ideal for extracting text from 1 million images file efficiently.